And I don't know, it's like there's a light at the end of the tunnel.
It's hellfire, Dean.
Yeah, whatever. You're alive. I feel good. For the first time in a long time. I got a year to live, Sam. I'd like to make the most of it. So what do you say we kill some evil sons of bitches and we raise a little hell, huh?
Don't get it!
Looks like your brother has some Campbell in him after all. Dean, you okay?
Yeah, I'm good.
Let's crack this piñata.
Roscoe?
There he is. I hope you brought marshmallows. Is he my old man?
Your old man's dead. They're all dead. So you can save me the speech on the, three hearts, the two spleens, the seven nipples for the ladies, or the fellas. I don't judge. But even with all that, you still only have one brain.
So?
No, 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 don't! Please.
Yeah. I do.
So, first, you'll die. Painfully. And then Crowley will watch his son die. Ditto. And then the king himself. And Blade destroyed. Well, that's quite a to-do list.
That old feeling makes me wonder how I ever had the strength to resist. This may be hard to believe in light of what I'm about to do to you, but I care about you, Dean. I truly do. And I know I'm doing you a favor. I'm saving you.
Saving me from what?
From your fate.
Has it never occurred to you? Have you never mused upon the fact that you're living my life in reverse?
My story began when I killed my brother, and that's where your story inevitably will end.
No. Never.
It's called the Mark of Cain for a reason.
First you'd kill Crowley. There'd be some strange mixed feelings on that one, but you'd have your reason. You'd get it done. No remorse. And then you'd kill the angel Castiel. Now that... that, I suspect, would hurt something awful. And then would come the murder you'd never survive. The one that would finally turn you into as much of a savage as it did me.
No.
Your brother, Sam. The only thing standing between you and that destiny is this blade. You're welcome, my son. What's the matter?
Tell me I don't have to do this. Tell me that you'll stop. Tell me that you can't stop.
I will never stop.
Thank you. little abrupt, but okay. Castiel, good to see you again. Thanks for the ride into paradise. And good on you, pulling that together, A+.
Well, you don't think this will work, do you? You trust that demon?
You sure I'm even me, Dean?
No, but he is. See, here's the thing when dealing with Crowley, he will always find a way to bone you.
This meeting's over. Did you really think you could trump me?
Honestly? No. Figured we'd have to catch you off guard.
He's coming.
Of course, I have a few conditions.
What?
It's a few people whose safety you have to guarantee before I say yes.
Sure, fine, make a list.
But most of all, Michael can't have me until he disintegrates you.
What did you say?
I said, before Michael gets one piece of this sweet ass, he has to turn you into a piece of charcoal.
You really think Michael's gonna go for that?
Who's more important to him now? You? Or me?
You listen to me. You are nothing but a maggot inside a worm's ass. Do you know who I am? After I deliver you to Michael.
Expendable.
Michael's not gonna kill me.
Maybe not. But I am. Beat me with a wire hanger, answer still no.
Don't test me.
Bite me.
Oh! Dean!
Phoenix Ash. One shell, 1 ounce of whiskey. Down the hatch. A little musty on the afterburn. Call you later, Mom.
Take you on more monster hunts.
I couldn't have done it without your pathetic, self-loathing, self-destructive desire to sacrifice yourself for your family.
That's awesome.
Right. Come on.
You know what? You're awesome.
Thanks. You too, I guess.